In today's free Affinity Photo Tutorial, I'm going to show you how to go from this photo into this photo, and I'm going to also show you how to edit RAW files in order to get amazing summer high key portraits. I'm also going to be talking about how I took this photo, what gear I used, and why I shot in broad daylight. But first, let's roll the intro. Hello everybody, this is Strato Ayani from illumis.com, the website and online academy where we create affinity photo tutorials like this one each and every week. Plus, we talk about photography, photo editing and photo techniques as well in order to help you get better at your craft. So if you are new here, please consider subscribing because why not? I mean, who doesn't want to listen each and every week my funny Greek accent talking about photography, eh? Yeah. Go figure. Anyway, let's dive into Affinity Photo because I'm going to show you something really nice today. And let's switch to my monitor right now in order to be able to see what I'm actually going to show you. Let's move me somewhere around here so I am out of the way. And let's begin. I'm going to take my RAW file and I'm going to drop it into Affinity Photo. And once I take this photo, because it's in RAW file, it's going to open into the develop persona. And as you can see here, this is my original RAW file, okay? It was taken with the Sony 6300 and it was taken during a portrait session that had as a subject a bikini photo shoot. What's wrong with me today? Anyway, the sun was very harsh, but in order to compensate for the hard sun, as you can see in the photo, here on my monitor, I placed the stand strategically at the top right corner of my frame and I asked Iro, our model, to turn around until her whole body was in shadow. So I don't have any funny highlights, I don't have anything that is standing out, and this is a great RAW file to start working with in order to get an amazing high key look, which is really good for summer photos, okay? So, I'm going first of all to bump up the exposure, so I'm going to grab the exposure slider and drag it to the right, and as you can see, immediately we have made a lot of improvements simply by dragging a single slider. Now, I'm going to also go over here to the shadows and highlights panel. I'm going to enable it by clicking over here in this checkbox and I'm going to drop the highlights slightly in order to get back some detail from the background. Now, in order to have an effective high key look, you need your background to be blown away to the point where you can barely see something. You don't want your background to be, for example, something like this, okay, pure white, doesn't look very nice. And also you don't want to pull the highlights all the way to the left because you can see the beach, it's kind of distracting and it doesn't look very good, especially for a high-key portrait look that we are going after. So just a tiny bit of detail and we're good, okay? Just a little bit detail needs to be brought back and not all the detail that your camera can record. And maybe, just maybe, I would go over here to the white balance tool and play around and make everything slightly warmer because why not? This is a summer portrait. Then I'm going to hit the develop button over here and it's going to develop the photo and bring it into Affinity Photo. If you want to see the before and after, this is the before, this is the after, before and after. Great, great improvement with just a few simple moves. Now, let's talk about color for a second, okay? Because this shot was taken under direct sunlight on a beach, the sand that exists at the floor, let's say, okay, reflects the light from the sun. Now, the sunlight is yellowish, so is the sand. So you are going to see that Iro's skin has a very interesting golden look to it, okay? So this is why I love it so much. Also, because I knew this was going to happen, aka Iro was going to have a very nice bronze or golden-like skin, I asked her to wear a swimsuit that is kind of reflective, kind of silver, kind of metallic. And as you can see, it fits perfectly with the frame. So have these tips in mind in case you want to shoot something like this. Now, since we are within Affinity Photo, the first thing that I want to do is go over here and select a curves adjustment layer. Okay, so I'm going to throw on top of my original photo a curves adjustment layer. Then I'm going to click here in the middle and I'm going again to click and drag this new control point to the left and upwards until her whole body is bright and nice. Okay, now as you can see, of course, I have blown out all the frame. I have blown out the background, I have blown out the sea, the sand, etc. But I really want this effect to exist only on her body. And in order to do so, I'm going to go over here to the curves adjustment. I'm going to click once on the name of this layer in order to rename it into something that makes sense. For example, brighten the body. Okay. Then I'm going to select this white rectangle that is the mask of this adjustment layer. I'm going to hit Ctrl I to invert it, meaning that I'm going to disable it for now. And then I'm going to select my paintbrush. I'm going to use my left and right square bracket key in order to give the brush a very nice and logical size that I can use to work comfortably on a rose body. And then I'm going to select as a foreground color the white color, and I'm going to paint this brightening effect on top of her body. And as you can see, her body really shines up. Now, the secret here is to actually stay away from the edges as much as possible, okay, as you can see here, because I'm going to do a small trick that is going to improve the whole effect a lot. Now, here I want to use my right square bracket key in order to make my brush a little smaller, in order to be able to work with the brush without any troubles. As you can see, I'm painting everything. I'm painting her face, her body, her hair. And if I mess up and I paint in an area such as this one, then I can switch to the black as a foreground color, and it will actually be used in order to erase the effect once again from this area. Okay, so this is a before and this is the after. Before and after, I can see that I have some spill over here. I'm going to fix it by painting into the mask with the black brush. Now, once I'm done, in order to make the effect look more realistic, I'm going to the blur menu from the filters menu. So I'm going to the blur, I'm going to select Gaussian blur, and I'm going to blur the heck out of it in order to blur the edges of this brightening effect that I just created. And this is going to make it look more realistic. As you can see, it blends nicely with the rest of the photo and it looks more natural. So I'm going to hit apply, and this is a before and after, before and after. Okay, huge difference if you ask me. Now, once we are done with this kind of editing, what we want to do is we want to play around with the color just a little bit, okay? So I'm going to actually select from here the selective color option, and I'm going to target the yellows. Now, selective color works like this. You select a color and you can add or subtract different color values. For example, if you go back to the Affinity Photo suite, you are going to see that for the yellow colors, I have four sliders: cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. And if I reduce the cyan colors from the yellow areas, you are going to see that we get a better teal-like effect for her skin tones. Okay, now this was kind of yellowish greenish, so I don't like this kind of skin tone for this kind of photo. So I'm going to select the selective color adjustment. I'm going to throw it on top of everything else. I'm going to select the yellow colors and I'm going to reduce the cyan until the colors look nice and warm on her body. Now, you can also play around with the yellow. You can add some yellow, but you will notice that it doesn't look very good. Or if you think that there is too much yellow, you can reduce the yellows from the yellows, because why not? And you can get a very nice balanced result. Now, if we say before and after of this photo, this is a before, okay, and after, before and after, you are going to notice that there is a small change, but it is quite substantial because it completely changes the feel of the photo. The photo looks more airy, more bright, and more high key. Okay, because it doesn't have this bright and this, let's say, saturated yellow color that existed at the original shot. Once we are done with all these kind of edits, we're going to select our background layer, and then I'm going over here and I'm going to select the developer persona. And once I'm into the developer persona, I will take a look and see if I can tweak anything else. I usually like to come back to the developer persona and add just a tiny bit of clarity. Okay. And I also like to tweak the saturation and the vibrance, because yes, I can do this kind of things with adjustment layers, but I prefer to do this kind of edits within the developer persona because the algorithm is different, I guess, since I'm getting different results. So I like the final result better when I do this kind of edits using the developer persona. So if the color is too bright or if the colors are too punchy and I want to go for this bright and airy look, I will reopen my original photo into the developer persona and I'm going to play around with the vibrance and the saturation until I'm satisfied. Plus I'm going to add some clarity to make things pop. Once I'm done, I'm going to hit again the develop button, so I'm going to get the final result back. And now it's time for the liquify persona. Now I'm going to use the liquify persona in order to tidy up some small edges around Eero's body. And usually what I do, if you notice here, you're going to see that this area over here doesn't have a nice curve, okay? It goes curve, flat, down, and then again curve. And this doesn't look very nice. Now, it's not Eero's fault, it's the pose's fault, aka my fault. So, because Eero is actually kind of walking towards me and moving her hands and her legs, because of the motion of her body, this kind of things can happen and can appear into your shot. So what you need to do is to go over here, select this tool, which is a liquify push forward tool, and then all you have to do is push around these corners slightly in order to create a nice even curve around her body. Okay, I'm not going to do anything drastic. I'm not going to slim her down at around 50%. Okay, I don't really like to do anything like that. I just want to make things look as they should. Okay, and I want to fix problems that appeared because of the way that I was posing and I was shooting my model. So I'm going to actually create a nice even curve here, a nice even curve again here. And I really like this pose because it creates a very nice S letter, or S, let's say, curve, and it makes everything look more organic and more pleasing to the eye. Once I'm done with a liquify persona, the last thing that I want to do is to experiment just a little bit, okay? Because the photo looks great as it is. Now, what I usually like to do is I usually like to go on top of everything else, aka on top of each layer, and add another layer that is the lens filter, okay? Now, as you can see, the lens filter is going to give you this very nice cinematic fashion looking color, and it's going to harmonize everything within the shot. Now, maybe this is too much for your taste, no problem. All you have to do is go over here at the opacity slider, as I said, or the optical density slider, and you can play around until you can have a hint of blue at the background over here, and also retain these nice warm tones within your photo, okay? And of course, if you don't like this color, you can click over here at the filter color square, and you can play around and add some red maybe, add some orange. If you want to make things look weird, you can add some teal, etc., etc. Okay, so you can experiment to your heart's content and you can find your very own unique style. Okay, Now, once we are done, I'm going to hit OK, or I'm going to close this, actually, dialogue window, and I think we are done. Now, once we are done, I usually like to throw on top of everything else a black and white adjustment. So I'm going to throw a black and white adjustment, and I'm going to switch it into, over here, let's find it, I'm going to switch it into luminosity mode. And by doing this trick, I can go into the photo and I can use the black and white adjustment with the luminosity blending mode in order to target individual colors and make them brighter or darker, okay? And first of all, I want to zero out everything, so I'm going to go over here, or maybe if I hit reset, no. Reset is going to place everything at the value of 100. So I'm going to zero out everything and again change the blending mode into luminosity. And also remember, pro tip, if you go over here, you can also change the blending mode from this dialog anytime you need to do so. Now let's go to the reds. Let's drag this lighter to the right to make everything brighter. Let's do the same with the yellows, and as you can see now, we are getting a much brighter and airy look, okay? So this is a before, more contrast, more punch, more color. This is the after, a more bright and airy look for your photos. Now, you may like it, you may don't like it at all, it's up to you. I'm just showing you the techniques, and you can use them if you want to, okay? You can play around with the green as well. As you can see, it affects the shadows at the background where the sea exists. You can play with the cyans, you can play with the blues, you get the point. You can brighten or make even darker some areas within your photo by selecting or targeting specific colors with this tool and making them brighter or darker. Okay? Again, you throw on top of everything else a black and white adjustment, you change its blending mode into luminosity, you zero out each and every slider, and then you play around until you get a look that you like. Also, since we are here, why not experiment with a completely black and white photo? So I'm going to deactivate the first black and white adjustment, and I'm going to use the black and white adjustment as it was meant to be used, okay? So I'm going to create a very nice fashion black and white shot. And as you can see here, it looks great, okay? You can play around with these tones over here. But basically what you need to do is you need to play with the yellow and the reds in order to get a nice result, okay? And as you can see, this photo stands very well as a black and white shot as well. So you can experiment and decide what you like most. So there you have it. Now you know how you can edit a RAW file in order to create an interesting, airy, bright summer portrait that was taken during harsh lighting conditions. And as you may have already heard, in photography they usually say, oh, you need a very soft light, it's not cool to shoot during the noon, the light is not ideal, you get very harsh shadows. As you can see, this is completely bullshit if you know what to do, okay? So if you are outside and you want to shoot something like this, a pro tip is to put the sun behind the model and have the model turn around until her whole body is in the shadow of her own body, if that makes any sense. And then you can shoot with a long lens like I did. I used an 85 1.8 millimeter Sony lens. You can take photos like this. You can underexpose just a little bit in order to preserve all the details, especially the highlights, and then you can use the magic of Affinity Photo in order to bring everything back to life, okay? So, make your model, turn it back on the light source, make sure you use a long lens, underexpose, and then use the techniques that I just showed you in order to create amazing, ethereal, and beautiful portraits like this one. And I have a bonus tip for you if you want to stick around for just a few seconds before I close this tutorial. And before we go to the bonus content, I want to remind you that if you like this video, we have a full-blown course that's completely free. Again, this course is completely free and it will show you how to create amazing cinematic black and white portraits. You can go at illumius.com, sign up for free, and you can get a full-blown course, again, I don't know how many times I have to say it, for free. It's no half-assed job, it's an amazing course, it's a complete full course as a sample to see what we are preparing these days and months, and you can get it for free. You will find the link down below. Okay, let's go for the bonus edit. Now, if you want to give this nice filmic glow, to this photo, here's a nice trick that you can use. You can go to the background layer that contains your whole photo. You can hit Ctrl J in order to duplicate this layer, and then you can change its blending mode from normal to screen. Okay? Then all you have to do is go over here to the filters menu, select blur, Gaussian blur it a lot, and I mean a lot, something like this for example, hit apply, and then drop its opacity to around 5 to 10%, and as you can see, this gives a very nice soft glow, which was and is a very popular effect among bright and airy shots like this one, photographers that use this technique, and some people use a filter that they put in front of their lens. But now, with the power of Affinity Photo, you don't need to buy a filter. All you have to do is use this technique and you can get this result. Again, you select the background layer with the photo, you duplicate it, you blur it, and then you change its blending mode from normal to screen, and you drop down the opacity to around 4 to 10% depending on the strength of the effect you want to create. So, wow, that was it, okay? We are here for about 21 minutes. This must be one of the longest tutorials that I have created over here. I'm sorry if it was kind of too long for you, okay? And let me know in the comments down below, do you want me to create more in-depth tutorials like this one, where I take a full-blown RAW file and I edit the photo from start to finish and I show you the process? If this is something that you are interested in, please let me know and then I will make sure that I will create a tutorial like this one again and again in the future. But I need to know, so give this tutorial a like, maybe subscribe, and leave a comment down below so we know what we can do for you at our next tutorial in order to be as useful as possible. Okay, that was it for today. Time to go out in the sunshine and enjoy the sun. Thank you very much for your time, and until the next tutorial, happy editing. This is Stratou Aggiani, and this was another tutorial from illumius.com. Don't forget to grab your full-blown free course at illumius.com. Go get it now. Come on, go. It's free. Go get it, because why not?